SME credit rating. This is a very important area that normally we do our credit rating for large companies, but SMEs can also be rated, and how CRISIL is really extending hand, we'll know from Mr. Raman. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chatterjee. Mr. Mitra from National Stock Exchange, Mr. Chatterjee, Mr. Sahu from Canara Bank, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's a huge pleasure for me coming here in Kolkata and talking about SME rating on behalf of CRISIL. I know this is a session just prior to lunch, so I understand it's a very tricky session. All of you are itching to go out and have some sumptuous food which is laid down in the next room. So I'll try and keep my session as short as possible. So CRISIL, I'm sure all of you know, I mean, it's India's leading rating research and data analytics company, and we've been into the business for the past 30 years. Finance and credit rating go parallelly, they go hand in hand. There's a lot of things to talk about when I say credit rating, and especially credit rating for small and medium enterprises. But still, we have short of time. I won't take much time of yours here. So I'll quickly talk about the new things which is happening in the banking industry, in the finance industry in India. Mr. Chatterjee gave a very good talk on GST and the kind of impact that has had on the industry as such and MSMEs in particular. We have banks here, Mr. Sahu would agree, the entire paradigm of banking and lending is changing due to GST in India. We are slowly and steadily moving from an asset-based model to more of a transaction-based model now, as far as lending is concerned in banks in the country. So now, coming to CRISIL and what we do in the rating space, and especially in the SME rating space, we've been present in this space for the past 10 years now, right from the time since the new MSMED Act was created in the year 2006. Since then, this scheme of credit rating of micro, small and medium enterprises came, wherein the Government of India through National Small Industries Corporation used to give a subsidy of 75%. So we are present from that day. That scheme was recently stopped. In fact, it was stopped in the year 2017. But we are still continuing to offer our services. We have basically two products that we offer to small and medium enterprises in this space. One is called an SME grading, which is nothing but a credit evaluation and assessment of an MSME on various parameters like your business risk, your management risk, the financial risks, and the industry risk. So it's more of a detailed evaluation, a due diligence that we do of an MSME on these stated parameters. We have formal MOUs signed with all the major nationalized as well as private banks in the country, in the sense that if you get a rating done from CRISIL, you can go to a bank and it helps you in taking limits, renewing of your existing limits, getting better interest rate from banks, lesser collateral depending upon banks' policies and things like that. Now, last year we recently started a new product. It's a digital offering. It's a very noble thing that CRISIL has started in the rating space in the country. We have started this product known as CCAS, CRISIL Credit Assessment Score. So this is nothing but a commercial risk management solution targeted specifically towards the micro and small enterprises in the country. So here what we do is we do an assessment of an enterprise, of a micro or a small enterprise, in as less as a couple of hours time. So there are very small list of documents that we take from you. Typically in credit ratings, there are a lot of entrepreneurs here sitting, a lot of MSMEs who are present in this forum here. So they'll agree with me that typically in a credit rating exercise, a lot of documents are supposed to be solicited from the rating agencies. But this product that we have recently launched, the digital project that CRISIL has, CCAS, we take just a couple of documents, that is your past 6 months bank statements and your history of your transactional data. So basis these two documents and income tax return, sorry. So three things basically, your last 6 months bank statements, your last 3 years income tax returns, and basis these two documents, we bring out a report. So all these reports that we come out with are acceptable, like I said, with all the banks in the country. And since it's a digital product, there's no human interface. You can just sitting in your office, scan these documents, upload it on our website. And like I said, the report can be generated within a span of a couple of hours. So I would in fact conclude my session because we are short of time. My colleagues are here, our stall is here right on the right hand side of the room. So if you have any issues, anything you wish to know about CCAS or other offerings in the MSME space, we are more than welcome to entertain you. Thank you very much. Thanks.
I think in credit rating for MSME, one of the major challenge could be that the books of accounts and statement of profit and loss and balance sheet. Because until and unless the correct financial position is reflected in the books of accounts, the rating will not really serve the purpose. So I think it is a major challenge for the MSMEs to show the correct amount of turnover, correct amount of purchases, correct amount of profit, correct amount of taxation. Unless these are reflected, it will not give a really good positions. This is what, even if you go for IPO, I have seen many cases, many MSMEs, they before going for a public issue, they always get the balance sheet audited by Big Four. This is a new trend we have also seen. For the last 50 years, they are getting it done by A, B, C, and D. But before going for a public issue, for 1 or 2 years before that, they are getting it. I think these are the major issues. Now, investors are also very intelligent. They are knowledgeable. So they understand what is there inside. So therefore, this correct books of accounts, maintenance of correct books of accounts, stating the right profitability, right loss, whatever it may be, is a very big issue before you really go for public issue, IPO, or even go for credit rating. Because credit rating is based on your books of accounts. Thank you. Now I would request Mr. Deepan Mitra, Manager, National Stock Exchange, to share his brief review on alternate funding opportunities for MSMEs.
Good afternoon, everyone. Dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, ladies and gentlemen. As Mr. Chatterjee rightly pointed out and just gave an introduction regarding why NSE is here. National Stock Exchange, we are the biggest stock exchange. And NSE, we started with an ecosystem for small and medium enterprises to access the equity markets for their financial needs. Now, over a period of time, we have been associating with Bengal Chamber of Commerce and I thank them for giving us one more opportunity. For small and medium sector enterprise, as it was pointed out by Mr. Chatterjee in his speech, that one of the major constraint, or you can say one of the concern areas, is basically capital. So when we talk about capital, it is either your own fund or maybe the bank or the financial institution fund. We present to you one more avenue of capital, which is the alternative source of fund or maybe the equity financing route through the stock exchange mechanism. I'll just take a few slides only which are of relevance here. The platform started where SEBI gave us the go-ahead in 2012 end, and our first company got listed on 2012. So what is this NSE Emerge? Small and medium sector enterprises who want to leverage their say equity valuation can participate in this particular market. It is the same platform whereby the larger corporates have floated their IPO and raised capital from the external investors. So now this platform, NSE Emerge, will help the medium sector or the smaller enterprises to float their shares into the public. The public will in turn subscribe them and the money comes into the particular company, which can be used as growth capital for expansion, diversification, working capital. Now the other side to the listing part is not only about generating funds, but also to give equity a particular valuation. Today, if we consider, say, all the entrepreneurs who are sitting here, you will always find that your equity is of no value to you currently. It is nothing but a mere piece of paper, or maybe if you're a limited entity, unlisted, you have got that dematerialized. But when we talk about creating a valuation for a company, the likes of the Reliance and the Tatas and the L&Ts of the world, we can also see a lot of other companies who are taking this equity route to give their equity a valuation. So the platform started, we got the go-ahead from SEBI. SEBI told that there would be some lesser norms and compliance standards for the SMEs, and NSC Emerge was conceived. And currently today, when you look into the data for NSC Emerge, you will see the facts and figures of the company, of the platform is like more than 200 plus companies are already listed on this platform. Till 16, 17 and 17, 18, say mid-year, it was a very boom period for the primary markets. A lot of IPOs got floated into the market. Of late, last 1.5, 2 years, you know how the markets are behaving. Markets are, you can say, hugely volatile. Of course, the last 5 days have been very volatile. And what we can say is, like, primary markets, it will only give an added dimension to the company. All these 200 plus companies who have listed, they have formed their own equity valuation and they are trading on a recognized stock exchange like NSE. Their market cap is more than 12,000 plus crores. And the average ticket size here is important. That means a company which is listing on NSE on an average is going for an issue size of 15 crores. So if you look into this SME space, you will say that this 15 crores is quite a good amount of money that SMEs can raise through this platform and can actually deploy that particular capital in expansion and diversification. Now there is this last point, which is the companies which have migrated to the main board. So here comes one more important aspect, that small and medium sector enterprise listing on NSE Emerge is a gateway towards listing. Once you complete 24 months, you are eligible to actually migrate to the main board of National Stock Exchange, whereby the bigger or the larger corporates with higher market capitalization are actually listed. So in short, you can say many of them, you can call like this is a smaller gateway to get into the listing foray, and then you can actually develop on your equity valuation and make your share also as competitive as your bigger competitors or larger corporates. Since we are sitting in, or we are talking and I'm presenting it in Kolkata, I should give you the Eastern region story. Now when we started, East was relatively, of course the equity orientation in the Eastern region is slightly less when we compare it with maybe the Western region. If you talk about the main board entities also, the West stands out more than the Eastern part. But the Eastern region story is also good. We have currently, you can see companies from hosiery, real estate, castings, plastic, polymers, industry chemicals, agro-food processing. All these, they belong to some in Bengal, some in Jharkhand, some in, say, Chhattisgarh. So MSMEs, as Mr. Chatterjee was also mentioning, like we have so many MSMEs across sectors. Like there are each and every sector, and NSE sector agnostic. It is not like only this kind of a company in this industry segment can only list themselves. You can come down on the exchange platform with whatever company growth you are having. The value proposition needs to suit the investor who want to invest in this company, and then you can get yourself listed. So Baba Agro in Ranchi, it's a rice branch. Srivasu Logistics into logistics. Hincon Chemicals is a homegrown company in Kolkata into industry chemicals. You can see Iris Clothing is the last one. They have a brand of kids wear called Doremi, which is a Howrah based brand. So all these companies from 4 crores to say 11 to 12 crores they have raised. The list also points out these companies who have already gone ahead and filed their offer document with the company, with NSE. So the process is like you appoint one SEBI registered category 1 merchant banker. Exchange, like me and my colleague, we will help you in identifying the merchant banker. You discuss in detail about with the merchant banker what are your prospects in the business, how you can create the value. If the merchant banker also kind of after doing the pre-due diligence feels like it is a company which is bankable and sellable in the market, then it will file the offer document. This offer document preparation takes close to 90 days to 120 days, maybe 3 to 4 months time. There are, say, on the finance part, on the secretarial part, on the objects part, as well as on the promoter details part. Once this due diligence is conducted, the offer document is filed on the exchange, like these companies have filed. Sylvan Plywoods, I hope most of the people here are aware about it. They are into the plywood segment. MK Roy projects, then Capcon India, then Atmasco Limited, a Bhilai-based unit in fabrication, BMW Ventures. Mr. Shah is sitting here, so he knows BMW, I'm sure. So these companies have already come forward. They have filed their document, and these companies will, in turn, say, in few months' time, will go for opening of their IPO. So the process is you get in touch with the exchange representative. The exchange helps you meet the merchant bankers. And once the merchant banker also creates a value proposition within the investors in selling the IPO, then we can take this IPO to the public. Just one more slide before I will finish. That is, these are the eligibility criteria. A company which is 3 years old, more than 3 years old maybe, at least 3 years in operation, and last 2 years should be in profits and having positive net worth are actually eligible. But frankly speaking, in this huge gambit of the MSME, I mean all SMEs or maybe small, medium sector enterprises might not find the space on the listing platform, because the value proposition should be something which should be attractive for the investors as well. So it should be, it has to be on mutual discussion with the merchant banker how they can place the issue into the market. The issuer's post-issue paid-up capital, that means the company which is coming on board, should not be greater than 25 CR. And the post-issue capital is calculated on the face value. So you can command any premium on the 10 rupee face value which you are currently having. So this is the major eligibility. Market making is there. And when you talk about the stage, you can say we are kind of placed here. That is the growing phase. You can say previously in this growing phase, companies used to only evaluate the private equity thing. That is another form of equity. But now NSE emerged. You can also, apart from private equity, you can look into the listing on a smaller platform of NSE, and then you can grow big and you can move to the larger platform. So major benefits for a issuer, that means when a company is issuing the shares, what would be the major benefit? I mean visibility. If you're an NSE listed company, you tends to be on Bloomberg, Money Control, ET, wherever you can be tracked. Any investor can track you sitting anywhere in India or maybe on an international location. One of the biggest, another important aspect or advantage, you can say, the banker is here. The shares, once they create a value, the banks also can leverage on the same, and you can leverage your debt with the help of your equity. A healthy debt equity ratio is always maintained. One more thing is like employee stock options is one more option once you become listed, if you can create value for your equity. You see the larger corporates like Infosys or HDFC or Wipro or maybe the TCS, the giants there, they have all given a lot of ESOPs to their employees, by virtue of which they can retain the talent. So these are some of the major advantages. And as I mentioned, so NSE Emerge is a platform for equity, and I would sincerely request all of you to evaluate this platform. I'm not saying that it's a one-day process. It is not like going to a bank or opening a bank account. It takes years. As Mr. Chatterjee mentioned about improving the financial health of the company, making the balance sheet robust, then taking it to the investor. My colleague Anshuman is here, so we both would be here around for some time now. If you want, you can get in touch with us and we can guide you. Thanks, Adan.
Thank you, Mr. Mitra. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any question, please raise your hand, identify yourself. Any question? Yes.
The mic, please.
Thanks to all of you, but my question is directed to the gentleman from Canara Bank. So with all due regards, I have been in the business for the last 6 years and knocking the various doors of the various banks for CGT MSE. Okay. And my experience is not very, very good, I would say. And what I do is a high-tech company. I run a high-tech company. And I believe we have all the numbers in our favor. And what we finally land up with is SBI extending some help in terms of 50 lakhs. But we have an order book which is in excess of around 10 crores now, and all are backed by Government of India kind of orders. And I desperately need. So if you be willing, and I would like to come down, and I would like to really explore, like what you say, is really meaningful.
I think you can talk to him on a one-to-one basis.
Thank you.
Any other question? So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your patient hearing. And now over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Chatterjee. It was a wonderful session we had on the Affordable Assistive Credit for MSMEs. We have a small task to perform from the chamber. May I request Mr. T.B. Chatterjee to present a token of appreciation to Mr. Kunal Raman, please. May I request Mr. Chatterjee to present it to Mr. A.R. Sahu. Mr. Chatterjee, Mr. Dipan Mitra, please. Now, may I request Mr. Moitra from our committee, sir. Mr. Moitra to Mr. T.B. Chatterjee, please. With this, we end our first half session. Now I request all our speakers, panelists, and delegates to join for lunch. We'll be assembling here maybe around 3 o'clock to start our next session. Thank you. Good afternoon, all of you. I request all of you to take your seats. We'll be starting our this next session shortly. After this, may I request Lieutenant General Aniruddha Chakraborty to come to the session, sir. Mr. H.R. Jagannath. Mr. Shekhar Srivastav. And last but not the least, Air Vice Marshal S. Borade. Mr. S.K. Dash of Vistara. Mr. S.K. Dash from Vistara. And last but not the least, Mr. Harihar Das of Gardenville Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited. May I now request Air Chief Marshal Arup Praha to take the proceedings forward. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are into the first session post-lunch for this seminar organized by Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industry. It's a slightly longish panel discussion. So post-lunch, I know, is very difficult to remain awake. And it's going to be slightly longish, as I said, 1 hour 15 minutes. We have 7 important panelists here with tremendous domain knowledge who will reflect on the topic, opportunities for MSMEs in defense production and maintenance repair overhaul requirements in terms of the weapon system, platforms, equipment that they operate. And the second part of this panel discussion would involve opportunities of MSMEs in civil aviation sector and the MRO requirements of the civil aviation sector. So let me introduce the domain experts, the panelists of this panel discussion. First of all, we have General Aniruddha Chakraborty. Aniruddha, will you raise your hand so that people can recognize you? Okay. No, he is basically an infantryman. He retired as the Director General of NCC, DGNCC, National Cadet Corps, one of the largest institution organization in the world, to my mind, which actually trains and inculcates discipline through various activities, extracurricular activities, etc., in the youth of the nation. But his expertise is there in terms of his exposure to defense industry. After his retirement, he has been passionately dealing with this aspect, and is very thoroughly knowledgeable about the policies, about the Make in India effort of India in terms of Indian government, in terms of indigenous production of defense industry, and the role of MSMEs in this effort. We have next Air Marshal Samir Burade, who is serving as one of the most senior officers, engineering officers, in the maintenance command of the Indian Air Force based in Nagpur. And his experience is tremendous in the field of MRO in the Air Force. The Air Force, under the maintenance command, has nearly 50 MROs, facilities and infrastructure, all across the country, called base repair depots and equipment depots, who look after the inventories of all the weapon platforms, equipment, etc., and systems that the Indian Air Force operates, which are sourced from various countries, be it the US, be it Europe, be it Russia, or former Soviet Union, and our own indigenous. So he has tremendous amount of expertise in the field of opportunities for MSMEs in